أخدم جيتك بحسينيتك وترجيتك
يا مولاي يا مولاي
حقق ظني وتقبلني لا تحرمني
يا مولاي يا مولاي
واقف سيدي ببابك واتأمن نظرتك وبشباكك مثلك.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، صلى الله عليك يا مولاي يا رسول الله، صلى الله عليك وعلى آلك الطاهرين، صلى الله عليك يا مولاي يا أبا عبد الله. يا ليتنا كنا معكم سيدي فنفوز فوزا عظيما. In سورة هود آية number 88 in the Quran, Allah سبحانه وتعالى says, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، قال يا قوم أرأيتم إن كنت على بينة من ربي ورزقني منه رزقا حسنا وما أريد أن أخالفكم إلى ما أنهاكم عنه إن أريد إلا الإصلاح ما استطعت وما توفيقي إلا بالله عليه توكلت وإليه أنيب. صدق الله. This ayah talks about Prophet Shu'aib alayhi salam. His people, Prophet Shu'aib alayhi salam, his people made fun of him, and they made false accusations about him and his message. He replied to them with wisdom, as the ayah indicates. He started with قَالَ يَا قَوْمِي. He said, oh my people. He referred to them as my people to show them that he is one of them. He said, أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِن كُنْتُ عَلَى بَيِّنَةٍ مِّن رَبِّي وَرَزَقَنِي مِنْهُ رِزْقًا حَسَنًا. Meaning, consider if I stand on a clear proof from my Lord and he has blessed me with a good provision from him. Then this great prophet Shu'aib alayhi salam continued saying, وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ أُخَالِفَكُمْ إِلَى مَا أَنْهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ. I don't want to do what I am forbidding you from doing. And this is very important for anyone who wants to teach others. For example, which means أَمْرُ بِالْمَعْرُوفَ النَّهِي عَلَى الْمُنْكَرِ. For example, if you want to tell someone to pray on time, to perform salat on time, you should start praying on time yourself. Then your advice would be more effective. So this is the point of Shu'aib here. Then Prophet Shu'aib said, إِنْ أُرِيدُ إِلَّا الْإِصْلَاحَ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُ, which means, I only intend reform to the best of my ability. Reform is the mission of all prophets. They intend to work hard to reform faith, ethics, good deeds, to reform and organize the social connections among people, as well as the spiritual connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, spiritual connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To reform and to fix the earth and to fix the world around them. At the end of the ayah, Shu'aib says, وَمَا تَوْفِيقِي إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ وَإِلَيْهِ أُنِيبِ. My success comes only through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Him I trust, and to Him I turn. Let's take a break.
ذكري حنيني محرم دنيتي ديني محرم راية بديني محرم دمع فعل.
As we said, this was the mission of Prophet Shu'aib alayhi salam. to reach this mission, the mission of reform, Prophet Shu'aib alayhi salam realized that the success and that he needs is to that the success he needs to achieve his mission comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And because of that, Shu'aib said, in him I trust and to him I turn. Similar to the way of all the prophets and on the same path of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, Ahlul Bayt wanted to seek reform in the nation of Islam. Going back to the topic we talked about yesterday, we need to realize an important point. 50 years after the death of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, there were two types or two views on Islam. On one side, there was the corrupt and manipulated view, which is the view of Bani Umayyah, represented and led by Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan. And on the other side, on the opposite side, there was the view of the original Islam, which was the view of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. This view was represented by the Quran and Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi did not leave us without guidance. It was narrated that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi said in the hadith, which is like the hadith of Thaqalain, إِنِّي تَارِكٌ فِيكُمْ الثَّقَلَيْنِ كِتَابَ اللَّهُ وَعَتْرَتِي أَهْلَ بَيْتِي. It's a long hadith, but basically Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi said that he left us with two things, and if we held on to these two things, we would never deviate from the right path of true Islam. We would never get lost after he leaves us. He said that the two things that he would leave us with are the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran, and Ahlul Bayt, the members of his family. As long as we are holding on to the Quran and Ahlul Bayt, we would never get lost. When Yazid was nominated to be Khalifa, Imam Hussein alayhi salam was the only one from Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam who was still alive. So Imam Hussein represented true Islam. Imam Hussein realized that Muawiyah led people for 20 years into the deviated and corrupt ideology of Bani Umayyah. Muawiyah manipulated the concepts of Islam to benefit himself. However, Imam Hussein alayhi salam committed to the peace treaty, which was signed between Muawiyah and Imam Hassan alayhi salam. In the peace treaty, Imam Hassan alayhi salam specified that Muawiyah should do three things. The first one was to follow the Holy Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet. The number two is to refrain from any acts of revenge against Imam Hassan's followers. The third point is to restore the Khilafah, the leadership back to Imam Hassan alayhi salam during his lifetime. And in the event that he dies, give the Khilafah to his younger brother, Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Muawiyah violated all the terms of the treaty. He was responsible for the death of Imam Hassan alayhi salam. He sent someone to poison Imam Hassan to make it easier later on to nominate his son Yazid. Let's take another break. We'll be right
back.
For 20 years, Muawiyah persecuted people who disagreed with him. As we said, he violated the peace treaty. He ruled people with fear and injustice. People were terrified of his power, And not many people had the courage to challenge him or express their opinion. And when he was about to die, he violated the peace treaty again when he nominated his son Yazid to be the leader for Muslims. He brought back the tribal monarchy. He wanted to erase the features of justice and equality which had been implemented by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The divine and spiritual aspects of Islam were fading away. He expanded his rule by power and force, and many Muslims, unfortunately, followed Muawiyah. They sold their moral values, and they sold their conscience to gain power and control. They exchanged faith and belief for silver and gold. At this time, at this point, Imam Hussein alayhi salam knew that allowing Yazid to be the Khalifa, to take the leadership of Muslims, means the end of true Islam, of the real Islam, the Islam of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. By nominating Yazid, Islam was about to be hijacked. Yazid did not believe in Islam. He did not even acknowledge the religion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. Imam Hussein wanted to bring back the original Islam. He wanted to defend the values of truth, justice, equity, and humanity. He wanted to defend the Islamic values, and he made it clear that he was ready to die for the sake of Islam. The first thing that he did was declaring his opposition to the nomination and leadership of Yazid. He was, as we mentioned yesterday, we mentioned his announcement to the governor, and we explained a little bit about what the events that happened at that time. Then he announced his reason for rising up. It was narrated that Imam Hussein alayhi salam said, "ما خرجت أشرا ولا بطرا ولا مفسدا ولا ظالما وإنما خرجت لطلب الإصلاح في أمة جدي أريد أن آمر بالمعروف وأنهى عن المنكر." He said, so he outlined his mission or like part of it there. He said, "I am not revolting I did not revolt in any arrogance or mischief or to spread evil or to show off. I am not a corrupt person. I am not an oppressor. But I only wanted to seek justice and to seek the reform of the ummah, the community and the nation of my grandfather. I want to enjoin good values and stop the spread of evil." There are some people back then and even now who wanted to twist the facts about the movement of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. They say that Imam Hussein alayhi salam, his movement was like any other revolution. They say that Imam Hussein alayhi salam wanted authority and leadership. That was never the case. Imam Hussein alayhi salam made it clear that he knew that he was going to die. He was told by his grandfather, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, that he would be killed. So why would he seek power or authority and control if he knew that he would be killed? It doesn't make sense. Let's take another break. We will be right back.
خدمتك ويروي حياتي ضماك بلا ما تمك انا الاقي ضياعي يا ما عشت على منبر وناعي ظلمة حياتي بلا ضوى لولا ضماك.
Here are some of the points to highlight the reasons that led Imam Hussein alayhi salam to rise. Number one is to keep the glory and the great reputation of the true religion of Islam by refusing humiliation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, وَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ وَلِرَسُولِهِ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Honor and power belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Honor belongs to the messenger and the believers. Imam Hussein alayhi salam wanted to keep the glory of the true Islam. The second point is to wake up the Muslim nation. Imam Hussein alayhi salam realized that most of the Muslim nation was in a deep coma. Most people surrendered their will and conscience to the authority of Muawiyah and Yazid. In order to inject life back into the will of the nation of Islam, the only way to resurrect the Ummah, the nation of Islam, was to spill the purest blood on the face of earth at the time, the blood of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. If it was the only way the religion of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi could be fixed, could be brought back, then so be it. Imam Hussein sacrificed himself for that cause. To show the last one here, the last point we want to talk about here. Of course, there are other reasons, but we don't have time to talk about all of them. The other reason we want to say here is to show the role of women in the reform of this nation. For Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam, the role of women in reform is central and essential. Khadija alayhi salam supported Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi with everything she had, financially and morally. It was narrated that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi said, مَا قَامَ الْإِسْلَامُ إِلَّا بِمَالِ خَدِيجَةَ وَسَيْفِ عَلِيٍ. The foundation, so the foundation of Islam was based on and grounded by the money of Khadija and the sword of Ali. Without them, Islam would not have been the same. Similarly, Fatima Zahra alayhi salam supported her father, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, from her early age. And then she supported Imam Ali alayhi salam after that. Now, at the time of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, women also participated in a revolution against Yazid. After the murder of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, his sister Zainab carried on the mission of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Zainab brought back the essential role of women to carry on and lead the mission of Prophet Muhammad, the mission of Ahlul Bayt. She was very strong and knowledgeable about true Islam. She showed great bravery in the face of the oppressors and murderers, in the face of Yazid. If it wasn't for Zainab alayhi salam, Islam or the revolution of Imam Hussein alayhi salam would have been erased. It would have been dead. Zainab's voice, her awareness of the mission, with that she was able to take the responsibility of carrying on the mission of reform. She showed great strength and she exposed Yazid and his followers. She faced them with strong arguments and powerful speeches. We will talk about these speeches in another day. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, wa salatu wa salamu ala Muhammadin wa alihi al-tahirin.